And the first type of tenant is a tenant I like to call Mr. or Miss Let Me Explain, or Mr. or Mrs. Hey, can I call you to talk to you about my situation? Right? You see, as landlords, we run into these folks all the time, right? You're putting out your rental ads, you're putting out your criteria in your ad or when people reach out to you, right? So people reach out to you and you're like, hey, you know, here's my my rental application, and it typically includes like a questionnaire, right? Asking questions about their income, eviction history, job history, things of that nature, right? Well, these people, this is like the immediate like red flag needs to go off the top of your head as soon as they do this, that these people are fucking crap, right? As soon as this happens, you need to immediately know these motherfuckers are crap and you don't want to rent to them at all. They're going to say something like, they're not going to fill out the questionnaire. They're not going to answer your questions. They're going to say, hey, before I fill out this application, can I talk to you for a while? I want to explain my situation. I need to talk to you about this before I give you my answers. Under no circumstances are these people you should ever rent to. There is never going to be a time where their explanation is going to be something good for you. It's always going to be some pulling at your heartstrings bullshit, right? Like, oh, I don't have a job. I can't pay the rent. I would be a terrible bet for you as a landlord. But if I can hook you into a phone call with me, I'm going to try to give you this woe is me story why you should take a chance on me. No, don't let it happen. Don't get yourself into that situation. The moment they ignore your questionnaire and your tenant application process, your screening process, and they try to lure you into that emotional conversation, you cut those sons of bitches.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to Holton Wise TV for more financial information, education, and entertainment.